Hello, my name is Nitin. A few days ago, we have received SPEAG's Module HAC2019 prior to release for testing. This module is long overdue and extends the capability of DASY 6 and DASY 8 systems to measure hearing aid compatibility or HAC for mobile devices according to ANSI C63.19-2019 standard. Module HAC2019 has been developed using SPEAG's latest GUI technology based on the Jupyter Notebook combined with the Module HAC2019 API server. The Jupyter Notebook interface is easy to use, flexible, and provides a customized user interface for specific measurement applications. Today, in this video, I would like to test the performance of the new module by taking measurements on real devices. First, I install the software using the common installer. This installs both the Module HAC2019 API software and the Jupyter Notebook interface. Module HAC2019 is fully compatible with the existing HAC hardware we have here. The arc phantom for placement of dipoles or devices under test with the associated holders, e-field probes such as the EF3 for radio frequency or RF emission measurements, audio magnetic field probes such as the AM1 DB3 for T-coil measurements, the audio magnetic calibration coil for calibration of AM1 DB3, the audio magnetic measurement interface MAIA for generation of calibration and audio signals for T-coil measurements, emission dipoles for system check, telephone magnetic field simulator or TMFS for system verification of T-coil measurement setup, modulation and interference analyzer or MAIA for measurement of the modulation interference factor. It should be noted that the MAIA replaces the audio interference analyzer, which was compatible with the previous versions of HAC software. But this should not be a problem since MAIA is a standard component delivered with every DASY 6 or 8 system. First, let me test the MAIA to see if it is able to measure the modulation interference factor for real-world modulations correctly. Here, I have a vector signal generator which has preset IQ files to generate real-world modulated signals. To test the MAIA, I will generate a 5G CP-OFDM TDD signal with a bandwidth of 100 MHz at 3500 MHz carrier frequency and feed the signal to the MAIA using the conducted port at the back. I switch the RF on button on the signal generator. I now start the DASY 6 module HAC software. I also start the API server. Next, I start the MAIA measurement Jupyter Notebook and connect to the MAIA via the API server. Then, I start the MAIA measurement. So, the MAIA reports a MIF value of -23.56 dB. I compare this value to that given by SPEAG in the communication systems database on their website, which is -23.48 dB. The difference is well within the combined uncertainty of the two measurements. With GSM GMSK voice modulation, the MAIA measures 3.23 dB, which is only 0.4 dB offset from the standard value. The MIF factor is directly used to convert the measured E field to the RF audio interference level for the DUT RF emissions. The MAIA can also be used in radiated mode via its antenna. Next, I will test the RF emission measurements with the Module HAC software. Before the actual device measurement, we need to first measure the system verification dipole in the RF system check notebook. For instance, here I measured the 5500 MHz dipole earlier, and the measured result for the maximum E field above the dipole is 97.4 volt per meter, which is only 0.13 dB from the target value 101.4 volt per meter in the calibration certificate for this dipole at 100 milliwatt power. I will now test the RF emissions from this test device in the TDD LTE band 41. The phone is set up so that the audio output is aligned with the reference point below the HAC arc phantom, and I initiate an LTE call using the base station simulator. An EF3 E-field probe is already mounted on the robot. Next, I start the RF measurements Jupyter notebook and run the application. This notebook has a tab display with setup tab for robot control, power on off and movement, home or park, and for teaching the light beam. I will now connect the software to the robot and move to the HAC arc teaching tab. The arc phantom is taught to the system by moving the probe manually with the help of the teach pendant to the three points P1, P2 and P3 that are marked on the phantom. For now, I will load these points from a file, as these were taught previously during the RF system check testing. So now I am ready to run the scan and move to the measurement tab. In this tab, I enter the dimensions of the DUT. The default grid dimensions shown in the grid settings are in line with those in the ANSI C63.19-2019 standard. So, I don't change any of these and move to the setting the communication system group, band and channel. If required, we can also edit the MIF value here to the exact value measured using MAIA. I then proceed to measure the grid. After the measurement is completed, the results are available in the post-processing tab. The average RF audio interference level for this case is 13.59 dB volt per meter, while the corresponding emission limit is 35 dB volt per meter. Thus, the device is compliant for this test case. It is also possible to look at the field distribution in terms of the interpolated, averaged or measured fields. Individual measured field components EX, EY and EZ are also displayed. Detailed test reports for any test case are available via this button here. It shows the details of the test, including the grid settings, measured values, and the field distribution. So the RF emission measurements with the new HAC module are both easy to use and at the same time precise. Next, let us look at the T-coil measurements with Module HAC 2019. The T-coil probe is a single axis probe that measures the magnetic or H field for the device in transverse direction. I will measure the magnetic fields from this telephone magnetic field simulator or TMFS as the DUT. The TMFS is fed with a 1 kHz CW signal from a signal generator, and the output voltage is measured on the oscilloscope to be 0.5 volt RMS. T-coil measurements are done in the T-coil Jupyter notebook. This notebook has a tab display with tabs Setup, Hack Arc Teaching, Calibration, Measurement and Post-Processing. The Setup and Hack Arc Teaching tabs are similar to those for RF measurements. I have already imported the teaching points P1, P2 and P3 from the previous measurement. The Calibrate tab provides options to perform angle calibration for the AM1DV probe in the Helmholtz coil, which is fed with audio signals from the AMI. Once the accurate angle for the probe is known, the probe can be oriented at the calibration angle, and its sensitivity and frequency response is verified using the calibrate button. In this case, the probe angle worked out to minus 29 degrees and the probe sensitivity is measured to be 7.24 millivolt per ampere meter, which is within 2.5% of the value specified in the probe calibration certificate. In the measurements tab, there are settings for the communication system, band and channel. I leave these unchanged as the TMFS is fed with an external signal, and proceed to measure with the default grid, which is in line with the standards requirements. The robot starts to measure the grid. The measurements are done with the probe oriented in the southwest direction, and the probe roll angle is set to the value determined in the previous step. The scan is now finished and the maximum value of H field for this orientation is minus 24.39 dB ampere per meter. This is only 0.2 dB away from the value mentioned in the calibration certificate for the TMFS. So what can we conclude from these test runs today? First of all, DASY 8 or 6 Module HAC2019 offers all what is needed to perform the evaluation according to ANSI C63.19-2019 standard. It is designed for fast and at the same time accurate compliance assessments. I particularly like that the customized interface performs the complex measurements in the backend without overwhelming the user with too many options. Thanks for watching the video.